Now, getting sounds into Grits was a bit of an interesting process. You see, we really didn't have funds to actually get a sound designer to make anything for us, so we had to act like a scrappy little startup. This actually started at the beginning. Where do we get our sounds? Well, thanks to the indie gaming boom of 2009, there's actually tons and tons of resources out there for independent game developers to go get sounds for free. So we employed that strategy. Now, when you do this, be very clear of what you're actually getting. Most sounds on the internet actually follow with some sort of weird licensing restriction, either Creative Commons or attribution or something along those lines. So when you grab your sound, make sure you understand how you have to credit it. Usually it comes with something. The second thing you have to worry about is when you grab a lot of sounds from the internet that were made from different designers on different soundboards, they probably aren't very unified, which means that they're not going to sound cohesive inside of your game. For this, you actually need to take your sounds through a post-processing tool. A personal favorite of mine is one called Goldwave. I've been using it probably since about 1998. It's free and easy to grab on Windows. Inside of these tools, you basically want to cut your sounds, trim your sounds, and make it sound as though everything is in the same environment. Case in point, there's a lot of little gotchas out there when you're trying to get good content into a game, and sounds are really tricky to do. So do your due diligence, post-process your sounds, make awesome.